This is a video on how to use CalcPlot3D tool to visualize a space curve. So let's suppose we want to look at a parameterized curve in the XYZ space using the CalcPlot3D tool. First step is under Add to Graph, Select. I click that little arrow, and I find in the menu Space Curve, R of T. I click there. And next, what we need to do is we need to get rid of this surface. It's just the default surface. So I click this little check mark, and it's gone. Now I see it gives us some default in terms of what space curve we might want. And this has this one. It's not the one I want. It helps us. So the next thing I must do is type in the x of t, y of t, and z of t, the space curve I might be interested in. Let's suppose you're interested in the space curve x of t equals sine of 2t. Y of t equals, let's say, t over 2. And z of t equals tangent of t. So I type in my three parametric equations into x of t, y of t, z of t. If I'm okay with t going from 0 to 2 pi, that's fine. Maybe I don't. Maybe I want it to go from, say, negative 2 pi to pi. I'm going to go t goes from negative 2, I type in pi for pi, to pi. And I could choose anything I want for t. And the number of steps, that will tell you how many points we're going to connect the dots. When a computer graphs something, what it does is it plots a bunch of dots, and then it connects them. So the default is 200. If I say go to 100, and that'll connect 100 dots and show the curve that way. Next, I need to click this little box. Allows me to view this space curve. I click that, and there's my beautiful space curve. Notice it looks like a bunch of curves, but that's because tangent, if you remember, is not continuous. It goes up, and then it comes back, and etc., etc. I can also trace. If I trace t equals 0, and if I animate, I can watch it move. And there it goes. Kind of fun. So there it goes again. I can also just use my mouse and I can drag it. I can go a little slower if I want that way. Look at what I need, and there it goes. Okay, the other thing I can do is I can look at a lot more features in this. If I click on this little gear button, it gives me all kinds of new things I can look at. But one of the things you might be interested in is, say, the unit tangent and unit normal. Maybe I don't want all this other trace stuff, except maybe the point. I think I want the trace point, which is going to also plot the point. If I undo these boxes, show trace vector, show velocity vector, and show acceleration vector, maybe I just want the unit tangent and unit normal. I can click those boxes, and now the unit tangent and unit normal shows up. Now I can watch it move and just look at the tangent and normal vectors for the point that I'm animating along this curve. You can look at other things. You can also, say, look at the binormal, the osculating plane, and we can see them appear as I click it. You can see the rectifying plane and the normal plane. Okay, I can also have labels shown. Now we have the tangent, normal, and binormal, and now they're labeled with T, N, and B. I can also look at the equations. Those will show on the upper left part of the screen. Now I see the equation for the tangent, normal, and the binormal. We can have some animation settings. So for example, continuous animation and bounce over range. I'll explain what they do. Now let's do some animation. If I click the animate button, so there it goes. Notice we have it bounce over range, so when it gets to the end, it bounces backwards. Okay, whereas if you don't have bounce over range, and hit animate, it goes, and then it starts over when it's done, instead of bouncing. So we can also do instead, let's suppose we only want to do a 2D. I know this is CalcPlot3D. Let's suppose we want a 2D visualization, because that's what we're looking at. We just have a space curve. What we can do is we can restrict to 2D. What this has done is it just projected onto the XY plane. What this does is it just ignores the Z of T and sketches out the X of T and Y of T. And now we can see the unit normal and the unit tangent vector in the XY plane on the space curve. Since this is CalcPlot3D, I'm not going to restrict 2D. You see there's also a check mark on use constant primary color. If you're using 3D glasses, you do need this checked. Otherwise, the 3D effect won't be as good. If you're not using 3D glasses, you can explore. And I don't know if you're in a multicolor mood, then you can check that, and we'll see other colors to look at. Not that important, but just in case. I'm going to look at constant color. So you'll notice there are all kinds of features in this CalcPlot3D adding a space curve feature. And I'll let you play around with each of these items to see the acceleration vector, the oscillating circle, the curvature value, in case you want the curvature, which happens to be at that point. A is 0.5 about. You can also click, if you click and unclick, this just turns them all on and off at once for this bottom stuff. All up to you. So explore, have fun, and thank you for watching this video.